reason, whenever we write the wave equation, we write in terms of your electric field. So how do you write the wave equation, beta? What is the wave equation? Can you tell me? Y is equals your A into sine of your omega t minus of your K into X. So now in the place of Y, we'll be writing as of your electric field vector E is equals to E naught into sine of your omega t minus of your K into your X population. Or if I'm writing in terms of a magnetic field, this will be equal to your B bar is equals to your B naught into your sine of your omega t minus of your K into X, because they are obeying the wave property property. And in this one, electric field is more dominant property. We'll be trying to take the electric field into the consideration right now. And how do you calculate the velocity of light when electric field and magnetic field is being given? You take the ratio of the electric field divided by the magnetic field. That will give you the velocity of light. This will come in detail in a chapter called as of your electromagnetic wave. But right now, just remember that velocity of light is nothing but ratio of electric field divided by your magnetic field part of relation. Is it clear for everyone? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now let us try to define the light in terms of your this propagation, beta. The light which is coming from the sun is an unpolarized light, beta. The light which is coming from sun is an unpolarized light. An unpolarized light, UPL, unpolarized light. That means it has both electric field vector and magnetic field vector. It has both electric field vector and magnetic field vector. That is called as of your unpolarized light. So that means I can say that light in which vibrations of electric field are distributed in all the directions in a plane perpendicular to direction of propagation is called unpolarized light. So what is an unpolarized light, beta? Light in which vibrations of electric field, we are having the vibrations of electric field and which have been distributed in all the directions in a plane perpendicular to the direction of the propagation is called as of your unpolarized light. Like say for example, if I am taking this one as of your like plane, okay? And in this one, light is propagating from here. If the light is present in upward direction, down direction, front direction, back direction, in this incline, and this one is inclined. So that is in all the direction in the form of the propagation right now. And this is nothing but of your plane. So the light in which the vibrations of electric field, isn't it? In this one, which is right now, beta? The dotted one which I am taking is nothing but electric magnetic field. The arrow marks which have been taken is nothing but a pure electric field. This dotted line, the dark light what I am drawing, it is nothing but magnetic field B naught. The arrow marks which I am writing is nothing but a pure electric field, because that is more dominant and magnetic field is not seen by our naked eye. But if we take electric field into your combination, so light in which the vibrations of electric field are distributed in all the directions in a plane perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of your light propagation is called as of your unpolarized light. Is called as of what? Unpolarized light part of relation. So this is the representation of your unpolarized light. Representation of your unpolarized light. Okay now. Ante oka arrow mark, one dot. This represents me unpolarized light. Dot and arrow mark undante, that will be your unpolarized light part of relation general. So this is your light part of relation like this. Anni draw cheyadam pratisari ibbandi kabatti. ఈ డాట్ ఈ ఆరో మార్క్ ఉన్నాయంటే దట్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ మీ యువర్ అన్పోలరైజ్డ్ లైట్ దట్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ మీ వాట్ ఫర్ మీ అన్పోలరైజ్డ్ లైట్ యుపిఎల్ ఇస్ ద ఫస్ట్ డెఫినేషన్ క్లియర్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీవన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ప్లేన్ అన్పోలరైజ్డ్ లైట్ ద లైట్ విచ్ ఈస్ బీన్ ప్రెసెంట్ ఇన్ ఆల్ ద డైరెక్షన్స్ the light which is been present in the, all the directions. All the directions ante dot represents me in and out, and the arrow mark represent all the thing which I can draw on the board like this. So every time drawing like a star is not possible for me. That is the reason an arrow mark and dot represent always me in unpolarized light part of relation. Is it clear for everyone? Let us try to go for the next part of this one. Next setting, beta. Plane polarized light. Plane polarized light. Plane polarized light. Okay. So what is happening you see right now? What I can do here is I can take a paper. Just take a paper. Thank you. Okay. Now see. This I'm taking it as of your plane beta, a paper. What I'm doing is, in this one, I'm making a small hole in this one like this. Okay, now, this is becoming right hand hole. So in this one, now this is your light beta. The one which is having, one is dark line which is inside, the another one is perpendicular like this. Isn't it? Now if I take a plain paper like this, and if I take this one to be incident on this one, now what is happening, you see, the moment it touches this, the black marker will get stopped. Avunagada. The black marker will get stopped and only the red one will be trying to go inside. That means if this is a dot and this is an arrow, so among these two, any one is being made to pass. If I take the slit like this, isn't it? This red one will be stopped. This red one will be stopped and this black pen can pass through this one. Isn't it? Among the dot and the arrow, if I'm taking the slit such that any one of the propagation has been going, that is called as of your polarized. In general also, if you understand the polarization, one general uses English usage look chustunta manam. Polarized jayadam and isolated. Or two persons unnaru ankonde, you generally see a lot this one in the foreign countries, black and white people ani. They get polarized. They are getting differentiated between them. That means they separate one group into your another group. That is called as of your polarization, I can say. That means if this is an electric field and this one is of your magnetic field, when this is going through a small slit right now like this, isn't it? If any one of the distribution is being stopped, that is called as of your polarized, because I am stopping one ray of light to pass through the slit. That is called as of your polarization. That is called as of your polarization. Now you may ask me, sir, what is the use of this polarization? Because if the light which has been coming from the sun, it has a lot of harmful rays along with that one. So in order to cut that wave particulation, we use the concept of your polarized. If you might have been seen the sunglasses, you might have been seen there are the sunglasses of Armani, sunglasses of Raymond's, which will cost you 20,000, 30,000, even 1 lakh. Because they are such a powerful that they can polarize the light in such a way that only one particular ray, which is not harmful for the eye, will be incident on the eye. This type of your sunlight glasses been used a lot by your, what you call that one, higher people. If you see it right now, the Raymond glasses, whatever you see, it is polarized. That the small it will be written on that one, it is polarized. That means it can polarize all the harmful rays which have been coming, and it can block it, and it can only pass the rays which has been useful from the given polarizer. Even while seeing a laptop, when you're seeing a laptop, Lenskot and your company on the right now for the optical instruments, which is also manufacturing the same. The blue light which has been coming from the laptop or maybe your phone, when you see it for a larger period of a time, your eyes get strained. So in order to overcome that one, we'll be using the spectacles. The vibrations which have been coming from that screen will be stopped. Only one or two particular vibrations which have been useful will be passed through the polarized ray of your glasses. That is the use of your polarization. Ante inkelet basically. So what is a polarization means? Cutting down either the electric or the magnetic is called as of your polarization. It's called as of what? Polarization part. Polarization allowed to the student right now. If this is a small paper which I have taken right now. So this is a paper like this. Isn't it? And in this one, there is a small hole. There is a small hole like this. Okay. Now in this one, this is the light of your propagation. Okay. The light which is being taken here right now, dot and arrow. This is unpolarized light. Dot and arrow. Unpolarized light, dot and arrow, unpolarized light. That means the light, it is an actually a combination of your wave like this, and there is another wave which is going perpendicular to this one like this. Okay, one vertical, one horizontal, isn't it? When it is been passing, it can pass the vertical oscillation and it will stop here right now, horizontal oscillation right now. That means the wave in which is been coming, this dot represents the horizontal, so that horizontal will be stopped. The outcome which is coming is only an arrow mark without any dot. This one is called as of your plane polarized light, PPL. This is your UPL, unpolarized light and plane polarized light. Is that condition clear? The light which is been coming here right now, it will pass only the wave which is been coming in this one in the vertical oscillation like this. Isn't it? So that is the reason we are getting only arrow mark, but we don't get right now this dark light. That means horizontal component of that, what you call that one, wave vibration is being stopped. So only one particular vibration is being allowed through this one. That is called as of your plane polarized. That is called as of your plane polarized. And ee instrument ayithe use chestunnam manam basically ga. This instrument is called as of your polarizer. It's called as of what? Polarizer. They are made up of different instruments beta. The best example for the polarizer is nothing but of your Nichols prism. Nichols prism. They are generally made up of right now calcite crystals or tourmaline crystals. Okay, so polarizers, as the best example is Nichols prism. They are either made up of your calcite crystals or also called as of your tourmaline crystals part of filation. Under deep ga manaku avasaram ledu, but just right now we remember that the one which is able to cut any one vibration, like ikkada horizontal vibration cut chese instrument ni manam em antunam, we are calling that one as of your polarizer. That is called as of your polarizer, and it is passing only the wave which has been vertically been passing. That is called as of your plane of your polarized light, plane of your polarized light. So there, see the definition of your PPL beta. PPL, this is very
important. Sir,
yes beta,
ki wave optics hai?
Ah, wave optics, last topic of wave optics.
Okay,
okay, okay, chalo. So plane polarizer is nothing but what? Vibrations of electric field are confined in only what direction? One direction. In one direction, in a plane, perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Perpendicular to direction of your propagation is called as of your plane polarized light. Is it clear? So vibrations of your electric field are confined in only in one direction. Here right now, vertical direction in a plane. Perpendicular to the direction of your propagation is of your called plane polarization. Like say for example, if I take the slit like this, now you need to tell me the answer. If I am taking the slit hole like this, and this is the light which has been passing through this one, and here I am having unpolarized light like this, dot and arrow. Now tell me which will be blocked and which will be allowed. Vertical will be blocked. This arrow mark will be blocked on only the dot which is been passing in horizontal will be passed. That means the light which is been coming right now is only having right now what? Dots. This is called as of what? Plane polarized light. It may be vertical or it may be on horizontal. Clear for everyone? Clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is about your definition. Like, see, this is the vibration which I have been taken like now. So this is a slit. Only vertical oscillations can pass through this one. Are you able to see this one? So if I am taking right now, only vertical oscillations can pass through this one. If I take like this horizontal component like this, only horizontal component of the waves can pass through this. Are you able to see it?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, I lost the power yesterday. Also, the same problem with me. Anyhow, chalo. So I hope you got a differentiation between what you mean by the unpolarized light and plane polarized light. Unpolarized light is a combination of both electric field and magnetic field. Plane polarized is either electric field or either magnetic field, anything. And in the electric field and magnetic field, which is more dominant, beta? Electric field is more dominant compared to the magnetic field. That is the reason whenever we write the wave equation for the light, we write in terms of electric field as E is equals to E naught into sine omega t minus of your k into your x. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Next one, very, very important terminologies we are trying to define right now. Let me take the screenshot of this one. Sure. Next one, beta. Polarization definition rasukuntunnaru osari. Polarization. Phenomenon of restricting the vibrations of electric field vector. Phenomenon of restricting the vibrations of electric field vector in one direction in a plane perpendicular to direction of propagation. Perpendicular to direction of propagation is called polarization. So phenomenon of restricting the vibrations of electric field vector in one direction in a plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation is called polarization. Is the definition clear for everyone, beta?
Yes.
Sure. Next one, and very, very important term. Plane of polarization and plane of vibration. This is also a 2-mark question for your board exams. Define the plane of polarization and define what do you mean by the plane of vibration. Okay. Student. Plane of polarization, that means in which polarization take place. Plane of vibrations, in which the vibrations of the particles have been present. In which the plane of your vibrations of the particles have been present. There are the two terms which we need to understand in the given condition. Like say for example, if I am taking the slit somewhat like this, this is the light. Okay. And this one is say for example of your plane. Roughly I am drawing it. And this is your unpolarized light. Okay, now when there is a slit like this in this one, okay, the one which is coming out is only vibration like this. Now tell me, what is the plane of polarization and what is the plane of vibration? Sorry. Yeah. Tell me, what is the plane of polarization? Plane of polarization means the plane in which the polarized has been happened. And what do you mean by plane of vibration? In which the vibration is being present. Can anyone tell me? Plane of polarization and plane of vibrations. Now, chudandi, please listen it very carefully. When this unpolarized light is being passed through this one, the vibrations which can pass through them, the vibrations which can pass through them is called as of your plane of polarization. That means the light which is being present in this one is called as of your plane of vibration. Plane of vibration in which vibrations have been present, waves are being present. Okay, the one which have been cutted and which has been stopped here right now, vertical component, whatever you are drawing right now. So if I draw a vertical component right now for this one right now, the plane which is vertical to this one right now like this. This one. Which has been stopping, which has been stopping. In which vibrations are absent. Vibrations are absent. Vibrations are absent. Is called plane of polarization. Is called what? Plane of polarization. And the plane in which, that is what plane? Horizontal plane. Like say for example, if this is the plane which have been taken right now. So the vibrations through which, the marker through which it is been going, that means this plane, whatever we are taking right now in this one, this plane is called as of what? Plane of vibration, in which vibrations have been present, in which the vibrations have been present like this. Now the one which has been cutting, this horizontal component part, whatever I'm taking right now, in which vibrations have been stopped, that plane is called as of your plane of your polarization. That is called as of what? Plane of polarization. I hope you roughly got an idea related to this one. రఫ్ గా ఐడియా వచ్చిందా లేదా?
Yes, sir.
So what do you mean by plane of vibration and plane of polarization? Plane of vibration means in which the waves are being present, vibrations are being present. That means arrow marks have been present. That plane is called as of your plane of vibration. The vibrations in which are absent, vibrations are absent. That region is called as of what? Plane of polarization. Because you have polarized it. We have stopped it. Isn't it? That plane is called as of your plane of polarization. Is that clear for everyone? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear up this? Sure. There's only one formula in the complete polarization, but it's completely a theoretical question. And even if you're getting the question, there is a direct questions which are based upon only on the plane of vibrations particulation. So let us try to go for the demonstration of the polarization of the wave beta that is given by a scientist called as a Malus. So that is the reason we are talking about your law of Malus. Law of Malus. See this one. Try to understand the diagram first. This is your polarizer. Crystal, generally get run to the. In this one is known as of your axis, through which vibration can pass. The another polarizer is somewhat like this here, slightly inclined. Okay. And axis of polarization. That means with the vertical, it has been turned by an angle of theta. So this angle is also theta. Okay. This one is a polarizer. I'm giving the name for this one as of your A1. We can also call it as of your polarizer beta, whatever it may be. And this one is called as of your analyzer. This one is called as of your polarizer. And what happens, you see? When the light is having an intensity this much, dot and arrow. This is having an intensity of I naught. That is having an intensity of how much? I naught. Can be sunda? Ibbanda avutunda. Okay. Now, when it is passing through this one, we get only arrow mark in this one like this. I get only arrow mark like this. That means here there were dot and arrow, so I naught. Now half of that one is been lost. That means intensity will be equal to how much for me? I naught divided by 2. Okay, now. And this one is in the form of what? Electric field vector. And then, this one is nothing but of your plane of polarizer. This one vertical is known as of your plane of polarizer. So this I can write here as plane of, for this one, analyzer. This one is your plane of polarizer, vertical. Now it is slightly inclined. So now when it is been slightly inclined, I can resolve that vector, because electric field vector is a vector kabatti. I can resolve this one into your x-axis and as well as of your y-axis. Resolve this, coach. If I'm taking this one as a dot line, this one is your plane of polarizer. Like this dotted line. And this one is your plane of analyzer. Plane of analyzer making an angle theta. Okay. This one is having an amplitude, say for example A. So if I resolve it, I'll be getting this side is A into cos theta, and this side it will become for me A into sine theta. A is amplitude beta. You can write that one as of your E naught also. If it is E naught, it is E naught into cos theta, E naught into sine theta. If it is a magnetic field will be equal to your B naught into cos theta, B naught into your sine theta. So this amplitude can be either electric field or magnetic field. Kabatti, I'm writing in terms of your A. So A is nothing but of your amplitude of the resultant wave. So this one is of a plane of polarizer, and this one is of a plane of analyzer. So through the plane of polarizer, whatever the amplitude I am taking, that is nothing but A naught A. And if it is right now inclined at an angle theta, so wherever it is making an angle theta, the other side will be cos theta, and perpendicular to that one will become for me your A into your sine theta partition. When the unpolarized ray of light is being passed through the polarizer, the intensity is becoming for me I naught by 2. Now this I naught by 2, when it is been passing through an analyzer, which is been inclined at an angle of your theta, Malus told that intensity is directly proportional to the square of your theta. That is nothing but of your cos square theta part of your relation. Clear for everyone? Light like picture and there. Confusion on me, mana. కనిపిస్తుందా ఓకే అదర్వైజ్ ఐల్ ట్రై టు డు ఇట్ ఇన్ ద టుమారో సెషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ క్లాస్ బేటా బికాజ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ ద హార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద కంప్లీట్ పోలరైజేషన్ సో ద కంప్లీట్ డెరివేషన్ పార్ట్ అండ్ ద అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్ విల్ ట్రై టు డు ఇన్ ద టుమారో సెషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ క్లాస్ ఆర్ మేబీ ఆన్ సండే మోస్ట్ ప్రాబబుల్ ఓకే చలో